I see, I am the fill in the blanks in this agenda because I wanted to be arranging this and not delivering the lectures here because it's quite stressful. But some of my friends, because of some pressures, have not been able to make it. And me and Rajesh are always filling up the agendas. So I hope I do some justice. I've just started making it today morning, but obviously I'll do more of talking and if there are some questions. And I will take less time, Dr. Bhide. So challenges. You know, the biggest challenge, what we see, starts with the test itself. Don't you agree? The biggest challenge is all of us are asking to begin with a triple marker, then a dual marker. That itself is a challenge. I think this topic should be, and which I'm proudly telling you, I have been talking to gynecs through Dr. Kothari in Indore, Bhopal, in Assam, and many, many such opportunities in Nagpur, where I say that please do not ask triple marker. That itself is the biggest challenge. People are not able to listen to what we are saying. The gray matter is very thick. So the topic itself starts with the test. Now, as sir said, Dr. Bhide, I think when we move in the market with the experience what we have got, we do get these questions from our clinicians and pathologists that, okay, where is the colored report? It's not asked as where is the risk analysis report. Haven't you faced this? The questions are also like this. Pardon my English because I have an inherent ability to get into Marathi. They suddenly ask, why is the bar in green, yellow? Nobody is bothered about the risk. What is the cutoff? The number three is, I have seen somebody patronizing, no. Don't do this. You know, if a lab gives you a report of 1:145, they say, nahi, don't go here, wo dusre lab mein jaake karwana. Now, is this a challenge? It is a challenge. Why are these challenges seen? Most of it are because of ignorance. I think we as, that's why APPI or CAHO is all, these things are done so that we drive this message across that not a particular lab or a particular test pattern, we have to look at the implementation of the test. Now, I have just gone through, I have heard about a couple of these programs which are available. People say, some of the clinicians will say, humko alpha ka report chahiye. Haven't you heard it? Like fetal medicine experts. I have seen people saying, nahi, humko colored graph wala report chahiye. Okay? Similarly, these are few things. But when we as pathologists are interpreting or immunologist or biochemist or microbiologist, I think what we should look at, I have an answer for the last 18 years, what I have done, is look at the program which suits, okay, your machine and your need. The reason I'm saying, I have, we had a very big conference where Shankar was there with us and Rajesh in Vidarbha Association, where we got a question that suppose we run, take an example, come to this Prisca, most of us widely use software. We got a question that if we do a beta HCG and AFP on, say, some different analyzer, we can take the name, say we do it on Abbott, or a Beckman. Can we do the maternal screen analysis for a quadruple marker on a Prisca? The answer is yes and no, both. Yes, because most of us, I don't say most of us, but some of us do it in large numbers. No, because when you go back to people of Prisca, which is, suppose if it is your software, and you have a query, you have a borderline report, clinicians are going to call you and say, nahi, lekin congenital anomaly scan to normal hai. You have seen most of the times patient coming. I had got one very funny incident when I recently started my setup in Nagpur. The patient called me on my New Year day, Gudi Padwa, and started firing. She said, we wasted more than 25,000 rupees because of your dual marker report. What has gone wrong? Her amniocentesis, you know, CVS sample was normal. And our report was positive. So where are the challenges? The challenges, as I said, start with the asking of the test. Triple. Number two, inadequate histories. Number three, variation of softwares which are used across. Number four, if the platform is Siemens and you're using Prisca, they stand with you as a company. But if you are using an Abbott and you are using a Prisca and you go back to the engineer or the company, they say ke the parameter is not run on our machine. So these are few challenges. I have some examples, but we'll move ahead. The most important ideal thing what I can suggest here is, ideally insist on the sonography which is done on the day of blood sample, the most recent sonography. Accept something with CRL and NT. The reason is you will give a better specificity to the patient and the clinician. And I feel like we are going to talk on NACO for counseling. Here also we should have counseling involved on the lab side, because we are the people who will get questions from, like this Nagpur patient who threatened me. Obviously then counseling did help us. We said, aren't you happy that the baby is going to be fine? This is a screening test, it's not a confirmatory test, but we have not counseled the patient and most of the time the clinicians. Okay, so these are few of the challenges as we move ahead. The fourth thing is, when we are selecting a program, let it be Prisca or Alpha or anything, please look at if the Indian moms are installed in your software. I'll tell you, we did a validation, I cannot divulge the data, where the German moms were included and most of the reports were positive. You can create havoc with your clinicians and your business and your EBITDA. Everything will go. So please look at all this. Now, complex elements. These are the complex elements. You are the person who is sitting on that ice. So you are at a danger. There is cold ice, so you're already lost your sensations. If you move, you're fallen. And haven't most of you heard this, faced this situation, that you're getting bombarded? If you say, ye form bharke bhejo, TRF, how many of you get a TRF which is completely filled? You know, most of the times when I send to sir also, my forms are incomplete. The reason is, we don't get the data. Just giving a date of birth and then you modify the date of birth fitting the age of the person, it's not going to help you. Number two, most of the times we see donor eggs nowadays. We see surrogate mothers, okay? All this needs to be filled in to get an adequately specific report, that is maybe 89 to 92%. So these are the elements on which you're sitting on that iceberg. It can melt, you can fall. If you know to swim, it's fine. But these are the things which you need. Yeah. So this is a common situation. Most of us are in that age where our children can tell this to their friends. That nowadays, this is what our parents do. Except few people who are young enough like Suvin, because they will take some time. So most of the times, how a clinician or a patient looks at you, this is how it happens. And trust me, this happens with every report, but the maternal screen report, I can see some smiling faces, but when you get this, it's very scary, okay? You suddenly get a call, ABC patient, you have given this risk, you have not by-hearted all the graphs, have you? So then I will say, okay, Dr. Shukla, why don't you read out the graph? He says, tumhala maiti nahi hai, I have given you, you have only signed it. So it's like a histopathology reporting. It is more of a personalized reporting. And this is how you get victimized. How do you stop this? I think the best way to stop is to control. Every challenge gives us an opportunity. Okay? So likewise, if we start streamlining, first, like I said, go to the previous one, get a proper blood collection with the pre-analytical details. Everything is NABL. Everything is 15189. If you follow that TRF properly, take the details properly, insist on a sonography, you can insist here in a metropolitan city that I want an FMF certified USG report. Just go to Gondia or a few kilometers away from here and you insist FMF full form bhi nahi pata hoga. Okay, you just get one chitti jiske upar likha rehta hai average week of gestation. 13.5. How can you take an average of 13.5? And then you are supposed to do an analysis report. Okay? On that, how is your specificity going to change? Moms, I said, insist on Indian moms so that your parents or your clinicians will start looking at you better, or your patients. You will not have this khunnas look on them. Now, so the next most common challenge which we face in maternal screening, it's like lipid profile. Haven't you in your younger days, sir, when you started your lab, when we were just born possibly, most of the times questions which are asked are, achha, lipid profile karna hai, kitna ghante ka fasting? Isn't it asked every day? Even today I get these questions. It's irritating at times, but you have to be patient and answer. This question I get asked every time. Okay, Aparna, you have to answer the question even in the midst of a conference. Okay, there is a patient. The week of gestation is, she'll keep you on hold. Then she'll say, 13.5. What should I do? A quadruple or a dual? So what is the right time? I feel so many times I have told them that the best time to do a dual marker is between 9 to 11 weeks. Why do you wait till the patient is on the border of POK? I mean, you just take her sample when she's between 9 to 11 weeks. So isn't it a challenge? How do you counter this? The best way to counter this is, I have written in my directory of services, though you write, but in Nagpur I have written in Marathi and in Hindi that please, these are the weeks where you do a dual, because I'm an infertility center, I focus on that. If you're collecting a quadruple sample, please don't come on the 22.5 days. No point in doing that test. Can you do a CVS on that patient? You can't. So better you come between 15 to 17 weeks. You have some more time for your further evaluation. You know, I would, this is a fill in the blanks for somebody else, but that's why so many thoughts which I ran through. There are many, many more challenges which possibly I would like to answer if I get questions from you all. But this is what I enumerated, and I hope I've done justice to the topic. Anything else which, one more thing which commonly we have seen is quadruple marker coming high risk, say 1:70 or 1:210, and where the cutoff we write as 1:250. The commonest challenge which we see is, now should we do an amnio? I think we should always counsel the clinician, tell him and her, him or her, if possible the patient, that boss, this is a screening test. 1:240 means you are having a risk of 1:239. Provided your QC is right, your ECAS is right, all that, I'm assuming that everything is right in the right place. In spite of that, if you get a negative report, please celebrate, because your baby is not that one, okay? I think hospital guys need to really be told, you know, what is happening here. And if at a risk or a MOM which is high, say for example, I always tell my clinicians that if the NTD risk, neural tube defect, is there, please follow up AFP after 1 week and look at the MOM. If the MOM value is coming down, possibly it's the early evaluation of quadruple. Follow up. We always say follow up within 15 days if you have the time. You know, with that, if there are any questions, I have saved time which we had lost. So I would like to take questions if there are. Otherwise, thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Aparna. So I'm, yes, ma'am.
The mom, like you said, Indian mom. So we see, like, you know, challenges of getting mom evaluation or median calculation in each week of gestation. Like, you will not get, like you say, like they don't come in the proper time and all. And sitting in a hospital or sitting in a reference lab. So we don't get any. Like 120 moms. Yes. 600, because FDA says 600 should be minimum to calculate the MOM. CLSI say 120 if it is Gaussian, not Gaussian, then 200. So then getting 120 also is a challenge at like, you know, some of the weeks of gestation. So then how to face that challenge?
I thought I would be asking you that, but good question. I think the best thing, madam, what I have done is, we did in my previous organization, obviously it requires a lot of data, we did a study with one of the large government hospitals and paid to the company to get basically Maharashtra moms, if you ask me, more specific. That's not needed. But now if you look at the top two maternal screening companies, I can definitely proudly take the name of Siemens, though they are not our partners, but that's the widely accepted one. They have their own Asian means and Asian moms and Indian moms. Once we purchase the software, they give us, and they give us the study of the data as well. because that's a paid study. The second one which I have seen is Perkin Elmer's. Even they have Indian moms, but it's only valid. That's my experience. Dr. Bhide may add his or somebody else, Dr. Rajesh maybe. If you use that data with Siemens, possibly, analyzer, I have seen a diverse kind of a situation in borderline cases. Like, particularly, we say as a pathologist or a microbiologist or a lab diagnostics, we say 250 is the cutoff. Like, I had a big session with Hema Purandare where we, you know, that's what helped me to learn that the cutoff 250 we take. But if you look at the gynecs, they take the cutoff as maybe 180 to 200. Okay? They don't go as high as 250. What's your experience? Maybe you can add. But to answer your questions, these companies, these two companies have really helped me. But if you go with Perkin Elmer system and not specifying Indian moms, then the reports are not matching. With the USG findings, mostly I look at the soft markers in the USG, like fetal cord noted, or, you know, there are, they give you that NT is high, and if your triple or a dual is normal, it's going to be not an Indian mom. That's what I have seen mostly. There's very less data, but actually we were trying to get even Dr. Gokte here for this session. But as I said, they have dropped out. Otherwise, it would have really helped. But this is what I have learned with these fetal medicine experts.
You want to add, Dr. Bindri?
And I think one more, like Rajesh said, I fight with my clinicians, don't send me a dual marker after 13th week. Because I have seen that you invariably get a very low mom of PAPP, very low mom. And then you're just wasting money of the patient and even adding stress. Because your report may be normal, but we also like to give a remark that mom of this is below 0.5. Because at least he gets alerted, but that alert causes anxiety, pressure. So better to avoid. So I say ke bhaiya aur do hafta ruko aur wapas aa jao for quadruple. I think that's the best way. So counseling is what I feel pre-analytical is very, very important. That
I think NT also has a big effect. So rather than biochemical parameters, if the NT is not properly measured, there's a possibility that the report may be false positive, even worse, false negative. So
Absolutely. That
false negative report, I think, is it can be a disaster.
See, I will add to this that definitely globally, like we have this doctor, I don't know whether you were there, we had called him in, I think the session was in one of the hospitals last year, where we did say that fetal medicine, yes, it is endorsed by MFF Foundation that you should be using the software which is only fetal medicine certified. Definitely. But if you look at Indian scenario, okay, and the correlation, I can't give you a blanket statement without the research or the correlation. Luckily, I could correlate around 4,800 plus duals and quadruples on both the systems. And I haven't seen, that's why I'm very confidently using Siemens, because I feel it has more acceptability, though it is not fetal medicine certified. But if you talk to Siemens head, they say they have applied. I have been listening to this for the last 6 months, but my gynecs are, and first of all, I don't want to do something wrong. I will endorse what is right. And I have done the correlation. So I feel that's more acceptable. And the moms which I am getting in Prisca are Indian moms. I am not sure about the moms on Perk. I am sorry. I have worked and I have seen they are not matching my clinical or USG findings. Because I was blessed to have worked with karyotyping data. Most of the positive samples, we have given the abortive sample to genetics lab because we were close and we could see what was correlating. Most of the times, even if the risk is not high or low, but a single mom, I have those cases, but unfortunately I can't show you, single mom of 0.2, we have got abortion in 18th week and we did the genetics karyotyping and we have got Edwards syndrome without a risk. So how vigilant pathology examination of a mom or a report can help our patient or a clinician is what I wanted to tell you. So, yes, and I agree with her, but I don't want to say it here. It's possibly, you know, it's like vitamin D3. I also don't want to comment that here, but yeah. Thank you so much.